Did you ask the Ukraine to investigate Joe Biden?
No, actually, I didn't. I asked the Ukraine to investigate the allegations that there was interference in the election of 2016 by the Ukrainians for the benefit of Hillary Clinton, for which there already is a court finding.
You never asked anything about Hunter Biden. You never asked anything about Joe Biden.
The only thing I asked about Joe Biden is to get to the bottom of how it was that Lutsenko, who was appointed, dismissed the case against Antac.
So you did ask Ukraine to look into Joe Biden?
Of course I did.
You just said you didn't.
No, I didn't ask him to look into Joe Biden. I asked him to look into the allegations that related to my client, which tangentially involved Joe Biden in a massive bribery scheme.
Rudy.
Not unlike what he did in China.
Rudy.
You explained to me how the kid got $1.5 billion
Rudy,
from China.
I have no problem
when Joe
with
Biden
you launching allegations. But just be careful about what you say. I asked you, did you ask Ukraine to look at Joe Biden? You said no. Then you went on to say that you did.
No, I didn't say that. What
Rudy.
I said was this. I asked them to investigate the allegations that relate to the false charges against the president of the United States. Those allegations tangentially involve Biden.
So your answer should have
been yes. Let me finish.
Did the president talk to the Ukrainian president about what he wanted done with Joe Biden and what he wanted done with Paul Manafort?
I have no idea. I never asked him that. I don't know if he did, and I wouldn't care if he did. He had every right to do it as the president of the United States. He had every right to say to the Ukrainian president, we have two outstanding allegations of massive corruption. And
did he ask you to do what you were doing?
No, I did what I did on my own. And then
really?
I told him about it afterwards because I'm his lawyer and I know how to investigate.
So you never talked to him about it before. You only talked to him about it after.
3 months after I found out about it. And then I found out that it was true by getting signed, sworn statements from five people in the Ukraine who said that we were brought into the White House, the Obama White House, and we were told, go dig up dirt on Trump and Manafort in January of 2016. You have no idea how big this is because you're blinded.
You're blinded
by your prejudice.
Give me the affidavits. I appreciate
the personal
insults.
I'm not going to give you the affidavits.
Why,
I'll give them in court. I'm not going to give them to
you.
Who are you?
I'm a journalist. You keep saying
the FBI.
Hold on, Rudy.
You can't indict anybody.
You want to say I won't cover it because I'm like this, right? You say?
Oh, man, when I
now you won't give me the proof.
I'm not going to give you proof. What can you do? You can't indict anybody.
Believe me,
the proof is in the right hands.
The president's personal attorney, spending nearly half an hour obfuscating, spinning, avoiding questions from Chris tonight on the show before us. While Rudy Giuliani initially denied asking Ukraine to investigate former Vice President Joe Biden, he then admitted doing just that just seconds later. We got to talk about it. Frank Bruni's here, Ryan Lizza, and Rick Wilson. Rick is the author of Everything Trump Touches Dies. Good evening, one and all. Frank, Rudy Giuliani told Chris tonight that he didn't know what the president did. But if he did do it, it was okay. And what Rudy did, he did on his own. And he told the president about it afterwards. I'm sorry. What did we learn from this?
We learned that Rudy Giuliani will say anything and mount any argument in his loyalty to the president, which I don't quite understand. I don't quite understand a lot of this loyalty to the president. But it's sort of absurd because we don't know what the president did, but regardless of what he did, it's okay. Now, what we think he's talking about is this sort of tit-for-tat aid in return for investigating Biden's son or something. If that is the case, if that's the way these dots connect, absolutely that's wrong. I mean, we've just gone through a whole chapter of American history where we've been looking at foreign meddling in an election and whether that was solicited and whether there was collusion and all that sort of stuff. And now we're looking at the possibility that the president invited it to happen again on his behalf, even as the rest of this, you know, was kind of coming to a head. It boggles the mind. I mean, I don't know how to react to that, Don.
Join the club. Rick, listen, I'm going to bring you in here because Rudy Giuliani, he contradicted himself multiple times, shouted personal insults at Chris, at the network, and on and on. Here's more, and then we'll talk about it.
Chris, you don't know what happened. I know what happened.
How do you know when I don't know?
You're just repeating spin. The prosecutor.
Oh, but you don't.
And you want to cover some ridiculous charge that I urged the Ukrainian government to investigate corruption. Well, I did, and I'm proud of it.
Well, then it's not a ridiculous allegation. You just admitted it.
All I can tell you is, if what is reported is true, it doesn't make a damn. It doesn't make any difference. If the president of the United States said to the president of Ukraine, investigate the corruption in your country that has a bearing on our 2016 election, isn't that what he's supposed to do?
Oh, okay. Would he be that freaked out if there was nothing to this story?
You know, I've known Rudy a pretty long time. I've been around the block with Rudy since 1997. He's pretty amped up tonight. That was a pretty high-intensity Rudy moment. And I will say the gem that came out of that, essentially, that we need to dredge up a little Watergate reference here, is he is basically saying if the president does it, it's not illegal.
It's not illegal.
Now, as much as some people are fans of the unitary executive theory, there are still things that are illegal. There are still things that are inappropriate. There are still things that are unethical. There are still things that are amoral. And what Rudy described is, in fact, that behavior. And you know, the fact that he admitted that he was pressuring the Ukrainians, you know, shows that this is a, and I hesitate to use this word because I'm not an attorney, it sounds almost like a conspiracy by Rudy's and Don's people to pressure the Ukrainians. The, you know, a high-low game. Rudy goes over to ask the questions. Don makes the phone calls. I think we've delved into something tonight that's pretty ugly.
Donald.
Wee little Donnie.
Don't say Don. All right. Listen, Ryan, Chris was very fair to Rudy, who was throwing out a lot of accusations. And then there was this. Here it is.
I'm sure they buy everything you're saying right now has nothing to do with distracting from what this president's problems might be.
I am not distracting.
You've been doing it for over a year and a half.
I haven't been doing that.
The hell you haven't. You've been distracting from the truth for a year and a half. And I hope you enjoy it, because this president got the benefit of something you built up for decades, your credibility. And you put it on the line for him.
On the line.
Good choice.
Wow. What's your reaction to that?
You know, I think in most of Rudy's appearances when he's defending the president on something, there's usually a debate as to whether he's just sort of mad. And I don't mean angry, I mean mad. And, you know, flailing around, and there's really no strategy behind what he's saying. And, or is he, is there a method to the madness? And is he setting the stage for arguments that they know they're going to need to make as more facts come out? So if you remember in the Stormy Daniels case, before all the facts of that case came out, Rudy Giuliani was on air saying, if the president did X, Y, and Z, what's the big deal? Mm-hmm. And that was before we knew that he had indeed done X, Y, and Z. And so the clip you played before this one, Don, that seemed like the same playbook, saying, so what if he called, you know, the president of Ukraine and said this? So
does
that's
that
either
mean to, in your
mind
that
he
did it?
Just spouting off. You know, it reminds me of the OJ book. You know, if I did it, he's either giving us, you know, a clue to the coming defense, and, you know, famous method of spin is to get those facts out ahead of time, so it seems like it's old news. Or he's just, you know, completely, you know, just, you know, freelancing, and this is not anything that's strategic. But I don't know. It looked awfully like what he did on the Stormy case, getting ahead of what seems to be the coming story.
Okay, Frank, you ready for this? This is from Rudy Giuliani. Well, let's put it up. A president telling a pres-elect of a well-known corrupt country he better investigate corruption that affects U.S. is doing his job. Maybe if Obama did that, the Biden family wouldn't have bilked millions from Ukraine and billions from China being covered up by a corrupt media. By the way, there's no evidence of that. There's no credible. I have no idea what that means.
But this is just insane, because in that tweet, he seems to be confirming, or at least suggesting, that in fact what was going on was saying investigate Hunter Biden. Yeah. Right before an election in which his most fearsome opponent might be Joe Biden. Rudy Giuliani has sort of lost his mind here if he thinks that he's actually kind of pressing a persuasive case. I tell you, though, when you pull back from this and when you watch that Chris interview with Rudy and the way he's behaving, it is perverse, and it's just inexplicable that a president who least deserves this kind of loyalty,
you know, and this kind of circling of the wagons and all that gets it time and again. And it's not just from Giuliani. I mean, he's the one making a fool of himself with Chris Cuomo there. But, you know, Bill Barr protecting the president, he seemed, the Justice Department apparently has a role in all of this, not telling, you know, the House Democrats what they want to know. The Director of National Intelligence, why are so many people willing to shelve their ethics and stick their necks so far out for this president of all people? It is one of the greatest perversions of this chapter of history.
I think there's a tear in the universe. It's not just like Mercury's in retrograde. I think there's like some space-time continuum that's like gone awry.
It's all a dream.
It's all a dream. Oh, when are we going to wake up?
Like, it's the wrong timeline. Like,
when is this episode of Dallas going to come to an end? When is it, you know, a dream? Who shot JR? Thank you all.
Thanks.